subscribe to Factly and hit the bell icon for updates.
Final exam tomorrow, but unable to concentrate because of the religious music entering your room from the street outside. Stepped out for a relaxing walk, but getting stressed out instead due to the blaring prayers from the loudspeaker. Or has your precious Sunday sleep been disrupted at 6 a.m. due to the virtues of a particular religion being proclaimed loudly at that very moment? At least one of these is bound to have happened to you if you live in India. And we often get worked up over it and whisper our frustrations to friends and family because we are afraid that officially complaining about it will be considered disrespect towards religious beliefs. And come on, you and I are ordinary people. We're not so brave that we are ready to take on the label of anti-secular in this day and age. But the fact is that the indiscriminate usage of loudspeakers affects our daily lives. And we should be able to do something about this. We're here to tell you that there are actually some rules regarding the usage of loudspeakers for religious reasons, and that as a citizen of this country, it is your right to invoke them if you feel like they're being violated. The Government of India came up with the Noise Pollution Control and Regulation Rules in 2000. These rules were formulated under the purview of the Environment Protection Act 1986. Section 5 of this rules document deals with the restrictions on the usage of loudspeakers, public address systems, and sound-producing instruments. We'll leave an article in the description for you to take a look in detail, but here we'll address the most important rules. A loudspeaker cannot be used without the written permission of a government-designated authority and cannot be used between 10 p.m. and 6 a.m. Further, the government can permit the use of loudspeakers between 10 p.m. and 12 a.m. for some religious or festive occasions for a limited duration of up to 15 days of each calendar year. In these cases, each state is considered a unit and every state government must issue the list of 15 days when this exemption would apply in advance. Even after permission is obtained, loudspeakers can only be used within the specified noise standards. In 2005, the Supreme Court upheld this 15-day exemption but also ruled that no further dilutions would be allowed to this law. Both the number of days for the exemption and the extra duration of 2 hours cannot be relaxed. It also ruled that the state government cannot redelegate the setting of the 15-day list to any other authority. And a breach of these rules would lead to a striking down of all the exemptions. Sounds great and ideal, doesn't it? 15 into 2, 30 hours a year of extra noise pollution should be bearable, given that ours is such a diverse country. And everyone should get to celebrate their respective festivals and occasions. But unfortunately, there are several issues related to the actual implementation of these rules and exemptions. It may not come as a surprise to many of us, but in reality, many people use loudspeakers in public without the necessary permissions. In fact, the petitioner of a 2015 public interest litigation claimed that most of the mosques in Navi Mumbai use loudspeakers despite not having official permission to do so. In this case, the Bombay High Court directed all institutions without permission to stop using loudspeakers. But in general, we know that police and other authorities often turn a blind eye to such violations of protocol. Another issue is that the list of 15 days to be given out by each state government is not really accessible to people. Very few states like Goa make this information public, so the people know when to expect more noise. Yes. Because we Indians think of Goa when we want a quiet, noise-controlled holiday. The Central Pollution Control Board monitors noise pollution in the 7 Indian metros of Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, Bengaluru, Lucknow and Hyderabad with assistance from the respective state pollution control boards. This is done through a network of 70 noise monitoring stations under something known as the National Ambient Noise Monitoring Program. The data shows that the average noise pollution levels generally exceed permissible limits in all 7 metros. In fact, the noise level assessment data for Diwali 2015 and 2016 shows that only 9 out of 70 locations in these 7 metros met the official daytime and nighttime standards. I know what you're thinking. It's amazing that even 9 out of 70 actually stayed within the limits, that too during Diwali. But that's exactly the problem, isn't it? Despite the government advisory, Supreme Court intervention, and health officials' warnings that the amount of noise around us is abnormal, we as citizens simply don't care enough to keep noise levels in check. We bring our jugadu attitude into this just as we do to everything else. And don't say it's hurting the sentiments of this or that community. If you're going to say that calling out azan is an integral part of Islam, you should know that there are restrictions on loudspeaker usage even in Muslim-majority countries like Pakistan and Malaysia. And even for other religions in our country, festivals can be celebrated without loudspeakers and loud music, like people did a few generations before us. Go ask your grandparents if you want. The truth that needs to be said, but no one wants to hear, is that we need to find ways to practice religion and nationalism in a way that does not cause inconvenience to even one person around us. Speaking of practicing religion, we now move to the protocol to be followed in taking out a religious procession in India. We know that our constitution guarantees us the right to freedom of religion. Part of this freedom is the right to carry out a procession. For this, permission has to be obtained from the official of the rank of Deputy Commissioner of Police or the DCP. The DCP grants permission for a procession if he or she is convinced that it will be carried out peacefully and harmoniously. This means that people wishing to take out such a procession must first provide all the relevant details to the DCP regarding the purpose of the rally and the route they intend to cover. In Delhi, if a procession is to cover more than one district, permission should additionally be taken from the police headquarters at New Delhi. In Puri district of Odisha, an applicant should apply in the office of the Superintendent of Police or SP. The Telangana Police website has a dedicated portal for permissions related to Ganesh Chaturthi related processions. Across India, once an application is submitted to the relevant office, it is reviewed by the concerned authorities, the feasibility of the proposed procession is checked, and permission is issued. In case the procession goes against the assurances made earlier and turns violent, the police can intervene and ask the organizers to discontinue the event. As such, the usage of force is considered the last resort and is usually taken up when certain conditions are violated. One such violation is if more than one-fourth of the road width is occupied by the procession. And of course, using loudspeakers without authorization or violating the permitted noise levels as per the rules under the Noise Pollution Rules of 2000 constitutes a violation too. Apart from these, specific places have specific rules too. For instance, in Delhi, one cannot take out a procession before 11 a.m. and after 5 p.m. Let's look at a few real cases that have dealt with these issues. In August 2000, the Supreme Court delivered a verdict in the case Church of God in India versus KKR Majestic Colony Welfare Association. The question asked was whether the beating of drums and reciting prayers on amplifiers should be allowed in the name of religion. The court ruled that the rights of individuals must exist in harmony with each other and that the enjoyment of one's rights must be in consistency with the enjoyment of another's rights. The court also held that no religion explicitly calls for prayers to be conducted by beating on drums and amplifiers, and that even if it does, such activity should not adversely affect the rights of others, including that of not being disturbed in their activities. So cute, yeah, this Supreme Court. Reminds me of Indian grandmothers sometimes. So full of good intentions, wanting the best for everybody, but the wicked people in the family don't want to listen to her. More recently, in 2017, the Madras High Court observed that the freedom of religion cannot be interfered with, but that the Supreme Court's guidelines on using loudspeakers for prayer calls from mosques should be followed as long as they are in compliance with the 2000 rules for noise pollution control. And it's not just the courts. The police and other bodies have been active in dealing with such cases too. In a single week in July 2019, Cyberabad Traffic Police booked 654 noise pollution cases against motorists who honked too much. Hyderabad City's police actually arrested at least 49 people around the city in 2017 for causing noise pollution. Again in 2017, the National Green Tribunal slapped a fine of 7 lakh rupees against a banquet hall in Noida for causing noise pollution. So, now you know the rules and procedures to be followed before taking out a procession or using loudspeakers in public. If you are planning to conduct a procession or use loudspeakers, make sure you follow these rules. And if you see these rules being flouted in your neighborhood, which is more likely, don't be afraid to report the violation to the concerned authorities. The rules of 2000 state that complaints may be made to the relevant authority if the noise exceeds the set limit or if loudspeakers are used into the night beyond the given deadline. In this case, authority means any authority or officer authorized by the central government or state government, which could be the district magistrate, police commissioner, or any other officer not below the rank of the deputy superintendent of police. Some states and union territories have dedicated helplines to combat noise pollution too. For example, the Telangana State Pollution Control Board has a toll-free number for complaining against all kinds of pollution, including noise, while the Delhi Police has a helpline specifically for noise pollution complaints. The Tamil Nadu Pollution Control Board has declared that the police department is empowered to take action relating to noise pollution caused due to loudspeakers. If there is no noise pollution specific or procession specific information available for your state or union territory, you can go to the website of the district collector or state police and register a complaint with either body. Apart from these, in most metros, you can approach the police through their official WhatsApp number or Twitter ID. We'll leave a few of these in the description for your ready reference. So, now you know that the next time a procession or a loudspeaker disrupts your life in any way, you can do more than curse your fate or clamp a pillow over your ears. With that, we come to the end of this episode. Like and share this video if you found it useful, and leave us a comment with your feedback. Thank you for watching.